Today, the Mavic 2 behind the scenes factory tour. Let's get to it. Hey guys, Felix here with Quadcopter Guide, and on this channel I help you get the most out of your drones and other filmmaking gear. Today, something pretty special. We get a sneak peek at some of the DJI assembly lines, and specifically how they produce the Mavic 2, the Mavic 2 Zoom. Now, this isn't the first time we've seen sneak peeks of DJI factories. As a matter of fact, back with the Mavic Air, some people got a little surprise if they didn't format their internal storage on the drone and they read out whatever files were on there. And you could access some people testing the video camera function of the Mavic Air. So that's pretty interesting. But today, this is a little bit more professional. It looks like a production team made this. Let's give it a watch, and then afterwards I'll point out some interesting things which I saw. Okay, so that was pretty cool. Let's see if we can figure out some of those assembly steps and look at it in just a little bit more detail. If you think I'm wrong or if you think that I missed something, do let me know in the comments down below. Can't wait to see what you guys think. Here you can see the precision stepper motors working to clamp the legs and the frame of the Mavic 2 100% precisely. They're using this to either test the fit of the arms or maybe they're adding something to the bottom. Perhaps that aluminum shell. This person is inspecting the bottom, so that makes sense. Here you can see the Mavic 2 in a special conveyor belt caddy, and from here, three of them at a time get grabbed and moved on. You can tell that the yellow blinking means that the drone is in a special DFU or factory mode, which is enabled during this production process. This is also impressive to see all those Mavic 2s side by side. Here, six of them get picked up at once, and all six will calibrate their bottom-facing obstacle avoidance sensors at once. Here, of course, they're one step closer to the end, and you can see the front LEDs are now red and the rear are yellow. The conveyor belt ends and the camera or sensors pick up a specific image. Now they covered the real image with a QR code, and that just leads you to some kind of a WeChat group or contact, so you can't make that image make your Mavic 2 take off and fly just like at the factory. Okay, this is pretty cool. Autonomously, these Mavic 2s fly along this planned path here. They do a spin move while testing its systems and then land on the next conveyor belt. Man, it would have been fun to be on the engineering team for this assembly line. This person here removes all the props. And here a USB cable is plugged in for final programming or testing. These steps here are so quick they cut out anything important so you can't really see what's going on. I assume all the screws are on board already at this time because the thing was flying, so I have no idea what the screwdriver may be doing. Here we've got an overview board of all the assembly lines. Looks like DJI also needs to install a Windows update on this monitoring PC. I'm not sure what these things are. What do you guys think? Are they gimbals? Second to last, you can see that part of the transport of parts is also automated. And finally, the tiny motors of the Agris T16 agricultural drone. And look, its status is happy. I can only imagine how much DJI has evolved in terms of their assembly processes and the technology and automation that they put in there since the Phantom 1 and Phantom 2 days. You can tell that they crank out quite a few Mavic 2s since the beginning of production of the Mavic 2. And you can just tell that quality is very top-notch. You can tell that the drone flies through the factory. If that isn't the perfect fly test, I don't know what is. And it's automated, so you don't have to sit there, bind the remote to every single drone. It just does it on its own. Pretty clever. Hey, if you learned something new or you thought that was pretty cool, then do give this video a like. It really does help out the channel. And of course, for more, don't forget to subscribe. In the meantime, check out some of these other videos. That's cool, but I encourage you to check out that one. Thanks, guys.